Embattled televangelist Apollo Kiboloy, now a fugitive from justice. Tracker teams have been formed to locate him after his lawyers received an arrest warrant for the pastor. Raya Capulong with the full story.
The Davao City Police on Wednesday served the arrest warrant issued by a regional trial court against the Kingdom of Jesus Christ founder and leader, Pastor Apollo Kiboloy. The Department of Justice earlier filed charges against Kiboloy and five others for their alleged involvement in the sexual abuse and qualified human trafficking of a female teenager in 2011. According to Police Regional Office 11 Director Police Brigadier General Alden Delvo, they went to the actual compound of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ to serve the arrest warrant. But only Kiboloy's lawyers were found to talk to them.
Pumunta kami sa Kingdom of Jesus Christ kay Apollo Kiboloy dito sa malapit sa airport at sinerve namin yung warrant of arrest, binigay namin sa administrator ng gusaling yun or na building na yun. And we have also talked to their lawyers, no, especially the lawyers of Pastor Kiboloy, if ever his client would want to submit himself to the authorities or the law enforcers as para siya makapag-bail, no? Because this warrant of arrest is bailable.
Delvo said they did not see Kiboloy in the area, but he believes that the religious leader is in Davao.
We haven't spoke to Pastor Kiboloy, but they were polite enough to let us, of course, enter the premises of the Kingdom and talk to their administrator and the lawyer also. Actually, Attorney Laurente.
Nasaan daw, sir, si Pastor Kiboloy?
Well, they would not divulge it, but we're just hoping that in the coming days, Pastor Kiboloy, along with his lawyers, will, you know, submit themselves to the authorities so that, you know, ma-process din siya and he could post bail.
Delvo added they have formed a tracker team to pursue Kiboloy.
Well, of course, just like any other warrant of arrest, there will be a manhunt operation, no? He will be a fugitive. Alam mo naman, we may warrant of arrest siya. The authorities will exert effort in arresting him.
The Davao City Police appeals to supporters of Kiboloy to avoid any trouble or violence and to surrender their leader peacefully. Meanwhile, three of the pastor's co-accused are now in the custody of the National Bureau of Investigation, Southeastern Mindanao. According to NBI SEMRA Director Attorney Archie Albao, they have arrested on Wednesday morning the chief of Barangay Tamayong, Crescente, Canada. While Pauline Canada and Sylvia Simania surrendered to the NBI office in Davao City in the afternoon. The legal counsel of the three individuals said they will post bail. Senator Risa Ontiveros is calling on Kiboloy to turn himself in and answer the accusations against him.
Bilang na ang mga masasayang araw ni Kiboloy, halos lahat na ng mga institusyon sa Pilipinas ay gumagalaw upang mapanagot siya. Pinapanawagan ko din kay Kiboloy na huwag nang mag-inarte. Ang dami na niyang ginawa upang takbuhan ang kanyang obligasyon sa batas. He should just cooperate and properly answer the accusations hurled against him. Kung walang kasalanan, hindi kailangan magtago. Muling higit na pasasalamat sa mga biktima ni Kiboloy na buong tapang na lumalaban. Papasaan pa at ang katarungan ay makakamit din.
Raya Capulong, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine senators want to clip the powers of the Protected Areas and Management Board, which is being blamed for approving permits that allowed commercial establishments to be built in protected areas. Details from Sherry Antores.
Philippine senators can't help but frown at the explanations offered by officials of the Department of Environment and Natural Resources concerning the construction of Captain's Peak Resort at the Chocolate Hills in Bohol and resorts around Mount Apo in Davao City. Both locations are protected areas that prohibit commercial use. Environment Chief Maria Antonia Yulo Loizaga pins the responsibility of approving permit applications to the Protected Areas and Management Board, or PAMBI, adding they don't have a say on such matters.
The membership of the PAMBI is dominated by the local interests. The DNR sits as chair. It does not vote. And the PAMBI can be constituted when the DNR is absent or not available because there is another pressing engagement by the majority of the members.
But Senator Nancy Binay argues the DNR is not totally blameless.
Secretary Lizaga, I agree with you na there are plenty of good people sa DNR, but at the moment, hindi ho natin siya nararamdaman.
Whenever there's a meeting, the sheer number of the attendees will outvote even the DNR.
Kung hindi yun na agenda, walang ia-outvote to begin with. Who initiated the permitting of Captain Speak and the others? Kasi parang pinapalabas niyo ho na, well,
yes, ma'am.
Na walang kasalanan yung DNR.
Senator Cynthia Villar questions the absence of DNR officials on the day the permit application for Captain Speak Resort was approved. Villar maintains that particular meeting would not have pushed through without the DNR's consent.
Parang ginamit yung mga barangay captain to approve the PAMBI certification. Kasi in a PAMBI meeting, ang secretariat is DNR. Kung ayaw maggawa ng meeting ng DNR, pwede naman nilang wag matuloy yung meeting.
Senate President Pro Tempore Loren Legarda also grilled DNR Assistant Secretary Gilbert Gonzalez, who signed off on the controversial project. He was identified as the agency's regional executive director in Bohol at that time.
Actually, nagkataon po na during this time, hindi po ako present during the PAMBI meeting. I was on an official travel in Baguio.
We will just leave it at that. Absent ako noon, so wala akong kinalaman doon. Yun na lang, ganun na lang.
Gonzalez insists they did their job, but blames the supposedly vague implementing rules and regulations of the expanded National Integrated Protected Area System, or INAIPAS Act, that allowed the approval of an environmental compliance certificate.
Hindi ko sinasabi na pumirma lang kami nakapikit dito eh. This went through a process. And we recognize the decision of the PAMBI in this particular decision, why this resolution.
Maski na may titulo, dahil dapat ang prioridad ay konserbasyon at proteksyon. Dahil magugunaw na ang mundo sa init at sa baha dahil sa pagwawalang bahala sa ating mga batas, ay mali po ang inyong interpretasyon ng aming ginawang batas.
Senators also quizzed environment officials on the proliferation of resorts near Mount Apo, one of which was even fined 50,000 pesos for putting up facilities without proper documents.
So anong balak niyo po dito sa wala pang clearance? At walang ECC, at alam niyo po na bawal, dapat wala sila doon.
We need to acknowledge that in some of these areas, there are titles. Alienable and disposable lands that are already with title. And therefore, we have no option but to recognize the rights and have that regulation be part of the LGU and DNR coordination.
The Senate Committee on Environment says it will expand its probe on other protected areas. But these early, both Villar and Binay see the need to limit the voice of village officials when it comes to environmental permit applications. The DNR, they say, must also be empowered to demolish structures located in protected areas, including those that have no supporting documents. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
China firing back at Manila's defense chief over his recent fiery statements against Beijing. China's foreign ministry now claims Beijing is on the receiving end of a real propaganda trap set by the Philippines. It insists the Philippines reneged on its promise to tow away the BRP Sierra Madre from Ayungin Shoal, making it a flashpoint in the maritime row between the two countries. China adding the Philippines must take responsibility for the recent tensions in the West Philippine Sea.
菲律宾方面一再指责中国以大欺小，而对其非法侵占侵犯中国南沙群岛领土的行径只字不提，这才是真正的宣传陷阱。仁爱礁问题不是谁大谁小的问题，而是孰是孰非的问题。菲方军舰1999年在仁爱礁非法坐滩， 严重侵犯中方主权，中方立即向菲方提出交涉，菲方也多次承诺拖走该舰。
菲律宾外交部高官还明确表示，菲方无意在仁爱礁上修建设施，不会也不愿成为第一个违反南海各方行为宣言的国家。但25年过去了，菲方不仅未履行承诺把军舰拖走，还企图运送用于大规模维修加固军舰的建筑物资。
Earlier this week, Defense Chief Gilberto Teodoro issued a rare open letter warning Filipinos not to fall for any Chinese propaganda that would deflect the issue of Beijing's encroachment in the West Philippine Sea. Now, over in Taiwan, at least 9 people were killed and hundreds more were injured after the country was hit by its strongest quake in 25 years. Zen Hernandez reports.
Videos from the city of Hualien in Taiwan show massive destruction after being struck by a magnitude 7.2 quake. Buildings collapsed, establishments like hotels were severely damaged, while roads were blocked by landslides. Judith Perdigoso, an overseas Filipino worker of 15 years, says she almost rented a unit in one of the apartments that collapsed. She also explains that quakes are quite common in Hualien, but this is the most violent they have experienced so far. There was even an aftershock as she was speaking with ABS-CBN News.
Sobrang kabado. As in, hindi mo alam kung saan ka pupunta, hindi mo alam kung anong gagawin mo. Yung mga kaldero, yung mga plato, nagsihulugan. Ayun po, may mga aftershocks po ngayon. As in, sobrang takot na parang feeling mo yung katapusan na ng mundo.
Even Taipei suffered from intense shaking as seen in this video. Many Filipinos evacuated their homes immediately after the main shock. Gino Lopez, a student in Taipei's Wenshan district, says Wednesday's quake was unlike anything they have experienced so far.
Yung mga aftershocks right after the earthquake, sobrang malakas din. Talagang parang lahat huminto. At saka yung trains po dito talagang huminto. Huminto lahat.
Taiwan's government says this is the strongest quake to hit Taiwan in 25 years. Around 77, including some tourists, had to be rescued from being trapped in road tunnels, according to Taiwan's National Fire Agency. The Manila Economic and Cultural Office in Taipei assured all Filipinos in Taiwan are safe. According to MECO, there are an estimated 170,000 Filipinos in Taiwan, 150,000 of which are workers, while the rest are residents or students. Many are in Taipei, but 1,400 Filipinos are in Hualien.
Dahil palagi naman nagkakaroon tayo dito ng earthquake drill, huwag po tayo magpapanik. And if ever po na kailangan natin ng tulong, alam naman po natin na nandito po lagi ang MECO para tumulong.
The massive quake triggered tsunami warnings in Taiwan, Japan, and the coastal areas of Batanes, Cagayan, Ilocos Norte, and Isabela in the Philippines. Preemptive evacuation was imposed on residents of Lawag City, with classes being canceled in 5 barangays, while swimming and fishing were suspended. 10 municipalities also had to evacuate and cancel classes in Cagayan, but all tsunami warnings were lifted after a few hours. In a post on X, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. extended sympathies and support for Taiwan. Taiwan President Tsai Ing-wen thanked Marcos and all those who sent prayers. She also said that disaster response is already underway and thanked Taiwan's first responders. The Department of Migrant Workers has set up a Taiwan desk and hotline for Filipinos who may require assistance. Zen Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Olympic team gets another member. Filipino weightlifter Elrin Ando secured her spot in the Paris Summer Games after a combined lift of 228 kilograms in the 59-kilogram division at the International Weightlifting Federation World Cup in Phuket, Thailand. Ando's achievement means the end of the road for Heidelin Diaz, the country's first ever Olympic gold medalist, who was hoping to qualify for her 5th Games. Diaz was ranked higher than Ando, but her combined lift of 224 kilograms was surpassed by the rising Filipino lifter. A country may only send one athlete per weight class to the Summer Games. Ando, who previously competed in the Tokyo Olympics in 2021, is the second lifter to qualify after John Ceneza. Another Filipino lifter, Rose G. Ramos, is still in contention for a place in the Paris Summer Games.